Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make kind of a grainy gradient texture. And we'll start off in Adobe Illustrator and then we'll move into Adobe Photoshop. And I'll also show you two different versions. First, I'll show you dark colors, and then I'll show you another way with lighter colors. A couple of the settings change. All right, let's get started. In Adobe Illustrator, I'm just going to make a new file. I'll make this 500 by 500 pixels and RGB color mode, and we'll create. Now I'm going to hit M to get on my rectangle tool, and I'll just click and drag holding shift to make a square. I've got my gradient window up here, but you can come up here to go to window gradient if you're not seeing that. And I want to choose this third option, the freeform gradient right here. When I click that, it's going to put a node in each corner. And now I don't need my stroke anymore, so I'm just going to get rid of that. I'll make sure my fill is in front, and then I'll choose the freeform gradient over here. Now I'm going to change this color. I'll double click it, and we'll just make this kind of a lighter blue. I'll make this one more of a darker blue. And I'll make this one a purple. And it's a good idea to have some significant difference between the colors. I'm going to make this one a light pink. And I might change this to maybe an even darker. Let's go with a teal up here. We'll make this a bit darker, and maybe this one a bit darker too. Okay, and this looks pretty good. I'll get on my selection tool, I'll make sure it's selected, and then I'll copy this. Then I'll come to Photoshop. I'll create a new file, and because I copied it to the clipboard, it's showing the clipboard here. I'm going to go ahead and change the resolution to 300 here, and we'll create. I'll hit Command 0 or Control 0 to view it at full size, and then I'll paste. I'm going to leave this as a smart object. That will allow us to make changes to it later if we need to, and I'll say OK. It does make it a little bit smaller than my screen, so I'm going to pull it out to here. Holding Option, you might need to hold down Shift too. That's Alt and Shift on a PC. And then I'll hit Enter or Return to commit the changes. I'm going to move my layers up a little bit so we can see those. I don't need my background layer anymore, so I'm going to drag it to the trash. And then I'm going to hold Option or Alt to click and drag this to make a copy. Now, this one that has a little smart layer icon on it, we want to keep as is. That will be the one where we can make changes later, so we won't mess with this. But this one up here, we're going to rasterize. I'll hold Control or right click and then go to Rasterize Layer. I'll come up here to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. I like a good chunkiness to the noise, so I'm going to put this at 16, and we'll put the distribution as uniform and monochromatic. And we'll say OK. I'll duplicate this top layer by holding Option or Alt and just dragging it below it. And then I'll get on that top layer. I'll change the layer mode to Multiply. And what that does, it kind of adds a little bit more depth. I don't want it to be this strong, so I'll put the opacity here at 35. Then I'll get on my second layer, and I'm going to blur this layer. Let's go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. And I like my radius to be about 1.3. You can also mess around with this depending on how much blur you like. We'll say OK. This just makes it look a little more natural to me. Next, on the layer you're on, go to Adjustments and then Curves. And I pulled out my Properties panel. You can also find that in Window if you're not seeing it. And then I'm going to bump up the top of the curve and bump down the bottom of the curve. That just gives me more contrast. And that's pretty much it. If we zoom in here, you can see all the little variations in the colors, and it's very grainy and chunky, and it just looks awesome. Now I'll show you how to do this with lighter colors. So here is another option that I made. I did this the same way with a freeform gradient. If we edit this, you can see the nodes I put in here. This one is white. Another thing I didn't show you before is if you click on a node and then use this bottom thing, you can have that take up more of the shape, and you can move it around to different areas to get a different effect. Okay, so I'm going to copy this. And I'll just hold shift and select these layers and then group them with Command G. And I'll call this the dark. Then I'll paste this in. I'm going to do the exact same process. We'll do a smart object. I'm going to move a little faster on this one. So I'll hold option and bring this out. And then I'm going to make a copy so I have the smart object down here. I can edit that later. I'll right click on this or hold control and click and rasterize that. Then we'll do the filter. We'll go to noise and add noise. We'll also do 16 here and uniform. And then I'll duplicate this layer again. And this top one, this time instead of choosing multiply, I'm going to do hard light. And that just works better with lighter colors, in my opinion. You can also try some of these other options and see what they look like. But I'll do hard light here. I'll put that at about 84%. We'll go ahead and blur that second layer. So filter, blur, Gaussian blur. That looks really nice at 1.3. We'll say okay. And then on that second layer, we'll go ahead and add curves to that. I'll bump this one up and bump this one down. So now we get more of a fade to white here, which is the look I'm wanting. So we get a lot of chunky texture in here and down here, but then it goes to almost completely white. We can still see a little texture in there. And that's how I like to do it with the lighter colors. So I'm gonna group these and we'll call them light. Then you could export these as a PNG file or a JPEG file. Then you could use these for print if you wanted at 300 PPI, or you could also make social posts at 72 PPI. And that's it. All right, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it. You'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.